Guys, look what I found on social media. It's a desk. And they claim that the bass goes all the way down to 15 hertz, but only at the sweet spot. So it doesn't reach the walls and you shouldn't get any noise complaints from your neighbors. And I want to find out if this is snake oil or not. So I've contacted Misha Jacobi and I'm going to find it out right now. So I'm here with studio designer Misha Jacobi, and I think you can better introduce yourself for the guys that do not know you yet.
Hi, I'm Misha Jacobi and I'm the designer of The Sphere.
How does a studio designer like you come up with the idea to create a desk like this?
Well, because of frustrations.
Frustrations.
Yeah. I have this long wish because I've built so many studios for so many clients, but I want to have my own studio. But I don't like the acoustic work anymore. It's too complicated. I mean, if you think about it, building a studio is one of the most idiotic things you can do because you want to create a room that doesn't sound like a room. So first, you have to build walls to keep the sound inside. And then it sounds like a parking garage. And from that moment, you want all the energy that is stored inside that room, you want to get rid of it. So the best studio is not a studio at all. The best studio is outside in a cornfield.
Yeah,
because you will hear only direct sound and you can hear what's happening.
Yeah.
So for me, it was like I want to create something that gets rid of all the variables. Because if you think about it, it's like there is this loudspeaker industry, there's an acoustic industry, and there is a studio desk industry. And that's what the Sphere is. It combines all those things together in a rather clever way.
All right. And what does it exactly do? Like, is this? It's not just a desk. It's like a whole concept. There's a bigger idea behind it. You can put this desk like everywhere.
Yeah, you can put it everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, do you need some room treatment, no room treatment? What is it
well,
doing?
Well, I would certainly advise some room treatment. The thing is, this desk talks to a room completely different compared to a normal situation.
Okay.
If it's possible that many professionals in the industry hear the same, then they can talk about the same.
Yeah, that's true, that's true. Yeah. I mean, every single room, what you just said, every single room has its own color.
It has its own color.
You want to create with this desk is that everybody gets the same color and has the same reference frame.
Yeah.
If I understand you correctly.
Yeah. We have made so many prototypes and at so many different locations. And once we got the first good measuring results, and we all start getting crazy. Is it really possible?
Yeah.
And from there, we had so much energy to finalize it. The whole idea of the Sphere is when the problems only reached till here, for example, then the room doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
And of course, that's not possible. That's not possible for 100%. But what we achieved is like that the reflections, there are still reflections. There's still some buildup, but it's like 30, 40 dB below.
So if I understand correctly, it's the desk and the sphere, which we can call this creation, is really containing the sound within your own bubble. Like I like to think of about a bubble around my head, but how is it exactly doing that? Like what is What is going on here?
Good question. In the past we had a typewriter and a calculator and a television. And somehow someone thought about, let's make a computer. So you type and you will see it on the television and you can do calculations. We call that a computer. This is the same thing. It's like, it's the ergonomics, it's the built-in loudspeakers, because I take away all variables, all the things that you can do wrong, it's not possible anymore. It's combining a furniture, acoustics and loudspeaker in one machine. And the best thing to think about it, it's not a substitute for a recording studio. It's more like a new tool for the music industry.
Okay, that's interesting. That's a big statement for my channel. So we're of course going to test that later. But yeah, it's doing some phase cancellation tricks, or what is it like? How is it making sure that the sublows are not reaching the corners? Like that's from.
Yeah, then I have to get a bit technical. You can compare a loudspeaker with a small studio, because inside that box there are also a lot of problems. In the loudspeaker industry, they've thought of so many solutions to avoid a boxy sound. The best way is no box at all. So none of these loudspeakers are closed.
Yeah,
they can breathe, and then you will have some benefits, but also some problems. For the people who know something about loudspeaker design, this is as old as it's the
super
first loudspeaker.
We're talking about
this is extremely old-fashioned. This is a technology that is being used for so long and. It's not used anymore because there are problems. If you have an open baffle loudspeaker inside a room, you need to take into account that it needs to be inside your room, because the same sound pressure coming out in the front also comes out on the back.
Yeah, you get a phase cancellation.
You get a phase cancellation and all kinds of problems. The whole shape of this desk make sure that you can use dipole loudspeakers against the wall.
It's all so for the viewers. Dipole is the dipole. Open back design, open design. Yeah.
Yeah. But in combination with the subwoofer and the backside of the low mid, they cancel each other out.
Then
you will get
Then you get the sphere that we're talking about. Yeah.
So it's not like when you do normal crossover, then the subwoofer stops and the low mid starts playing. Not the case.
Yeah.
I need the back wave to cancel the sub and the other way around.
Yeah. So who did you make this desk for? Like, is this for the like average bedroom producers, or what is your goal with this desk? Where do you want to see your creation?
Well, actually, I made this only for me myself.
Ah.
Only because
so that's
because I've made music in the past. I've worked with so many artists and designing studios, and I never had a studio myself. Yeah, it's like 15 years ago, and I wanted to have the perfect sweet spot without the hassle of air conditioning and building, and it saves a lot of cost.
Yeah.
So I actually made it for myself, but at a certain point, I had this feeling like, yeah, but if it's really good, why not try to make other people happy? Because that's my whole goal. Like when I'm designing building studios, I can do maybe 2-3 a year.
Yeah.
So when you turn it around, it's like for me, it's okay, then I can make 2-3 people a year happy.
Yeah.
Let's hope that I can make them happy.
You try to make them happy, but...
Yeah. With this, it gets bigger.
Yeah. You can produce way more of these than you can produce studios.
Yeah. Yeah, but it was not the whole idea to, from the beginning, oh, we're going to mass produce something. This is actually, because it's a complete no compromise approach, this is a Formula One car,
yeah,
but we also supply the roads. Most loudspeakers are measured in a dead room, and that makes sense if you want to see, like, what is the loudspeaker in combination actually doing? It's like
it's isolating, just focusing on the loudspeaker.
Yeah,
but it makes no sense in a real world environment.
No,
those measurements,
and they know that, but there is when you have a furniture manufacturer. They don't talk to the loudspeaker industry, and they also don't talk with the acoustic industry.
They're so separated.
Separate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is this desk also aimed at? Is it coloring or is it actually more neutral sounding?
It's as neutral as possible.
Okay.
This is one small remark, because if you put it really, just turn it on.
Yeah.
You will start hearing it. You will say, like, oh, I already hear a lot of bass.
Yeah.
It's direct radiating.
Yeah.
And when this would be a normal setup with a subwoofer, the subwoofer will be below the threshold of what you can hear.
Ah, of course. Yeah.
So this immediately starts coupling, like,
yeah. Okay.
It gets you. And that can give the idea of when I have it further, then I hear too much bass. No, this is a complete different situation.
Different approach, yeah.
Maybe interesting to know that this whole room is just two layers of gypsum.
Yeah. Plasterboard for the American. Yeah. So this is like a really, like, if I can say, shitty room. Yeah.
No, this is the worst room ever.
Yeah.
But that was just to make my case.
Yeah.
I mean, what can go wrong? I mean,
we have to find out what can go wrong. So maybe let's start listening and maybe do some measurements and see what this thing is capable of. So it's of course a cool story, but it doesn't end with the story. I really want to bring across to you guys what this desk is doing. It's of course very difficult, but I'm going to do my best. And I took a lot of stuff with me to bring this across. So what I first want to do is show you guys the difference between the desk and, well, some other speakers that we added over here. And we're going to do this with a stereo mic setup, which we're going to record over there. And we're also going to do some measurements, so you can also visually see what is going on.
First of all, the measurements I'm showing are absolute measurements. This means that both the speaker setups were playing back at the exact same volume. For the freaks, I'm going to publish all the measurements on my Patreon page. What we see here is the measurements of the near field speakers. We've measured at the sweet spot and near the back wall of the room. The blue line shows the sweet spot and the brown line shows the back wall. Now if we look at the 50 Hz area, we see, as expected for such a room, a small boost. Now, if we take a look at the measurements of the sphere, we see something completely different. The green line shows our measurements at the sweet spot, and the blue line shows our measurements at the back wall. Here we see a drop of around 10 decibels at 50 Hz. This is a pretty significant difference and was clearly recognizable both in and outside of the room. Let me demo this a bit further with some audio. We're going to listen to a stereo mic setup consisting of two DPA 4011s in the two positions we've measured on both systems. As you can hear, the bass of the sphere is way more contained. And now I'm going to listen myself. how the stereo image behaves. Like it's, of course, it's not a wide angle that we have. It's still very focused in the center. Oh, okay. It's almost like there are some extra speakers somewhere over here. And still, it's not that focused that you cannot move your head around anymore. Like I can still do this. Without major changes in the audio. Let's turn it up. I think this is one of those systems that you easily turn up too loud, too easy. Now what I sense is that when used wrong, this desk, it's not really a tool. So you have to understand what this desk is made for. If you ask me, this desk is not made for your enjoyment. It's not here to listen to your favorite music to. Because you would immediately notice and hear what is actually wrong with the music. Which is also the whole purpose of this desk. When you want to listen to what you've created in a very accurate way. And that's what this desk is representing. With the added benefit that you... like. You don't need to care about the room acoustics or your neighbors. So that's pretty interesting. One of the downsides of this desk is, and while testing today, we noticed that as well, you really have to sit over here. Like if you're working with colleagues on the side, that could be kind of an issue. That's something you have to keep in mind. Another thing is that like, if you want to listen to this desk, if you ever see one of these desks and wants to listen to it, you have to sit over here. Don't stand over there and try to form an opinion about it. I really recommend sitting over here because the difference between the sweet spot and the rest of the room is really big with such a desk. And that's it for this video about the Sphere. I know you guys are wondering right now, like, what is this thing going to cost? Well, the version as it is over here is going to start at 30,000 euros. Also, they're going to produce 30 of these at first, and later on they're going to produce more. So if you're interested, I will link to Jacobi underneath this video. Now, I want to thank a few people before I'm ending this video. First one is of course Jacobi for the hospitality and showing me this desk. Second one is Leonard for the measurements and the help during this day. And the third one is of course Krijn, who is filming this video. Now, if you like my videos and want to support me, you can do that by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to link over here. Another way to support me is by buying my merch or watching more of my videos. So I'm going to link one of them over here. Now, I want to thank you a lot for watching. Keep pushing and bye bye.